Hello guys, I hope you're okay and you have been well. So this is now our next video in which we are going to create our custom API file using C++. We are going to pick up from where we left last week. And then in this case, we already created our particle cluster data. We need three things when we are create when we want to create our custom rock model. Okay. We need the following. We need the particle cluster data, which we have, and then we need our C++ or .dll file, which will be our custom factory. And then we need the particle replacement file. This particle replacement file is the one that's going to dictate when the bonding will start and which particle we are going to replace with which one. So you need three things. You need particle cluster data, custom API, and particle replacement file. Custom particle cluster data is the one that we have it dot text, and particle replacement file is dot text. Okay. Now, but for the custom API file, we need now to go to C++, which is dot DLL. Now let's go now to the next part. For you to create the custom API file, you need Visual Studio and also the C++. You need the backbone files, which can be accessed at EDM User Forum, and in which you must be a customer to get, so that you can modify the codes the way you want to. As you can see, we have our particle cluster data, in which the total number of particles exported from our geometry, from our imported geometry, is 588. Now, the next thing that we need to do is to go now to EDM, to go to the SRC files, which can be accessed, okay, now from EDM User Forum. Now let's go to the where my custom files are. These are them. They are here. Now we need to copy this in the folder that we need to create our DLL file. So let's create a folder called Project API. Now we need to copy them here. So let me copy Control A, Control C. But some of these, apart from the source files, some of these, they are already available when you install EDM. There are some which are available there, but it's always a good idea to go direct to EDM User Forum. You can get them. Now the next, we copy them here. So this is where we want to create our project. The next thing that we need to do is to launch Visual Studio. Visual Studio. So let's go now to Visual Studio, and then we see what we'll do. Now here you create new project, and then you have to browse location where you want it to be. So let's browse for our location. We go to EDM. We go to Custom API. We go now to Project. We put it here. No, we've not put it here. So we go now to where our project is. Our project particle bed project. And then we say Project API. So this is my folder. And then we call it project. Let's just call it Project API. And then we click. You see, create a directory for solution. You can check this or not. It's up to you, but it's always a good idea so that when the DLL file is being output, it will be in folders, because you have the release and the debug version. So the release version is usually more optimized than the debug version, and is usually a smaller size, about that 6 KB somewhere there. Now here you don't click finish. Okay, you go to next. Once you go to next, select DLL and empty project, and then I'll click finish. Now let's see what happens. It's going to be a very short video. Now here we add files. We add the header files. We go to add, then existing items, not new items. Now here we go to the root folder in which we copied our SRC files. So I think it's here. Then you arrange by type. You click this one, and then you go down up to shift, hold shift like that, because they are header files. You see their header also here. You add them like that, And then we go now to source files, not resource files, now existing items. Now we go down like that. Then we say add. Now here, this is where now we get the custom factory that you want. Okay. Now this is the one. So you click, it depends with the SRC files. The one that you've got, you click the one that has quotations, number of particle in cluster, like that. So this is what you modify. Now we have 588 particles. Now we change this, the number of particles in cluster, to 588, like that. And then we control save. Now the next thing that we need to do, don't touch the other ones, don't touch them. And you can see why we need to, you remember I told you, you have to name your particle cluster data in this format, particle underscore capital, like that. It's because it's going to be called, we are going to call that .txt file, .txt file. We are going to call it, the DLL that's going to be created is going to be called. And even if you click the others, you'll see that they are also going to call it. As you can see, we have particle replacement preference. This one is for particle replacement preference. The one that you're going to say which particle is going to be replaced. Now the metaparticle is going to be replaced by the particles that are going to form the bond. And at what time? So you have to make sure that you name them well. Now, once we put 588 here, you go to build and then you go to configuration manager. You have to put it times 264. Come here, you click new and then times 264, copy settings from Win32 because that's what we started when we started with. Click OK and then you go to debug, then you click release like that. As you can see, it's in release. Then you close, then you go to build solution 7 and then let's see down here. So it has said build it's 1.0 failed. If you want to change to debug, you go to configuration manager, just click here and then debug like that. It's always in 264. Say close, then we are going to build, then we are going to navigate to see both of them. So every other time, even if your cluster data has different files, once you have the SRC files, you just launch your project and then you just change the number of particles here and then you compile, use that as your custom factory. You don't always have to come and create a new project every other time. Now we already have now our release. So we come here and then we see what we have. So project API, then we have times 264. Remember I said it's times 264. Now we open it and now we have the debug version. It's 188 KB. So this is what we are going to load. And now we have our release version. Okay. Now let us use this. You see it's 35 KB. Now let's copy this. And then you copy it to the root project, to the root folder of our project. Like that. And then we paste like that. Now we need now the other file, the last file that we need to copy here. Now we have the DLL file. Now we need now to copy one last thing from, it's also available from EDM user forum. So I'm going to use mine, the one that I have been using for quite some time. So I'm going to copy this one because I've been using this one, particle replacement prefs. I copy it and then I go here and then I'm going to open it and then we see what's inside here. Now in this case we have particle to replace, this particle replace whole, and then particle in cluster fraction. Okay, and then now we start bonding time. Now this is when I want my bonding, it's in seconds. So at 0.01 second I want the bonding to start at that time. Now we are going also to use this, we have to remember this, the way they are named, not they are not in small letters, it's fraction in capital letter. So with that, we are not going to go further today. I just wanted to show you that, and then by the end of the week I will have created the other tutorial. Yeah, thank you, and always I keep urging you, if you like my work, consider subscribing.